Hello viewers, I welcome you once again to today's lesson, and your tutor, Mr. Mwangi Francis. Welcome to Elimu TV, which is your station where you watch and learn. I'm taking you through chemistry, Form 4, and we are discussing radioactivity. So this is lesson 3. Previously, we have introduced ourselves to radioactivity, types of radioactive decay, and now today we are going to look at a few calculations in this lesson that will enable us to advance more on radioactivity. So by the end of this lesson, you will have been able to achieve the following objectives. We'll define the term half-life, and in addition to that, we'll be able to carry out simple calculations involving half-life. So, radioactive decay. We have previously mentioned that unstable nuclide disintegrates, that is, it breaks up to yield a new nuclide of different composition with emission of particles and radiation. So when this happens, the mass of the original nuclide decreases with time, since there is spontaneous disintegration. So as the radioactivity continues, the mass number decreases with time. So what is half-life? Half-life is therefore defined as the time taken by a radioactive isotope to decay by half its original mass. As it continues to disintegrate, to break up, the mass decreases with time. So the time taken for it to be half its original mass is what we refer to as half-life. So for instance, if we had a radioactive isotope, a sample with 100 grams, as it continues to disintegrate, it will reach a point when it is 50 grams. So the time it takes from 100 grams to 50 grams is what we refer to as half-life. So what is the importance of us understanding half-life? So the term is commonly used to describe how quickly unstable atoms undergo and reactivity, or how long unstable atoms can survive in a radioactive decay as the process continues. This knowledge will help us to do some few calculations, and it is the same that we are going to apply later, and it is what have been used previously in carbon dating, determining the age of fossils. So for us to do this, we have to approach these problems in two ways. Problems involving half-life can be approached in two ways. One, that is, it may involve calculating the amount of the original mass of the isotope before disintegration, or calculating the remaining mass of the isotope after disintegration. So we are going to look at each of these approach one at a time. So example one, 80 grams of a radioactive isotope decays to M grams in 100 days. Given that the half-life of the isotope is 25 days, calculate the remaining mass of the isotope. So we have the original mass, which is 80. After each 25 days, the mass decreases by half its original mass. Therefore, after 25 days, 80 grams will be 40 grams. After another 25 days, the 40 grams will be 20 grams. And another 25 days, the 20 grams sample remaining will be 10 grams. And this process continues after a long period of time until the isotope becomes stable. So we have the time of decay given to be 100 days, and after each and every 25 days it decays by half its original mass. So from the illustration above, how many half-lives do we have? Half-life is abbreviated using the letter N, so we take it by dividing time of decay by the half-life. So we have 100 divided by 25. And this gives us how many half-lives? It gives us 4 half-lives. That is, we have first half life here, you have the second half life, third half life, and the fourth half life, amounting to a total of 100 days. So maybe we may have more than 100 days, and this process may appear to be tedious. Maybe we are going for 1,000 years. So it means we will continue and continue, and this may make the process tedious. Therefore, we have the half-life formula, where T is the time of decay, and small t is the half-life of the radioactive isotope. Therefore, for us to get the half-lives abbreviated as N, we take capital T, time of decay, divided by the number of the days taken for each to go half its original mass. So that gives us N. So it follows that the remaining mass can be arrived at by using the same half-life formula. Applying the formula to solve the problem above, M, the remaining mass, is given by half raised to the power of the number of half-lives multiplied by the original mass. So from this illustration, N is number 4. A half remains constant since we are referring to half-life. That time remains constant. And from our calculation, we arrive to the same mass, which is 5 grams, which is the same as the 5 grams we have from the first approach. This can as well as be illustrated in a graphical question. Or that is a graphical representation where the half-life is constant. So we may have several half-lives, and that gives us the kind of graph that you have on your screen. So have we been able to understand this? For us to be able to see whether we have the concept, it is very important for us to answer the following questions. Question number one, you are required to define the term half-life as used in radioactivity. And then question number two, apply the knowledge, either the first approach or the second approach, in solving the following question. How much of a 200 grams sample of iodine-131 is left after 48 days, given that its half-life is 8 days? For you to get this content much more better, it's important for you to revisit this course book. That is Secondary Chemistry Students Book 4, which is which was published by Kenya Literature Bureau, or you can refer to M. Patel, Chemistry, Secondary Chemistry, published by English Press. For more information on radioactivity, contact us on the numbers on your screen, and you'll get to know more about radioactivity and much more. May God bless you.